Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very pleased to be here this morning. And first, let me thank you all to be here and to listen to me. I'm quite proud to represent our group here, Orange, and our chairman and CEO, Stéphane Richard. Big thank you for the organizers of the DLD. We have been a partner, and especially to Yossi, to the other founders, to the co-chairman, to the festival, and all the team. We have been partner of the DLD for the last 8 years. I'm quite happy, and I think for us, it's an occasion to come, an occasion to discuss with you, an occasion also to benefit from the last days for us Europeans of a good summer weather before really coming back to start to work. For decades, this country has been successfully combining different dimensions: Mediterranean, European, American, global. The unique location at the crossroads of three continents and with strong ties to the rest of the world certainly helps this success. But the most important driving force are the people. Let me also remember you what was said in the Book of Wisdom, and for us, digital people is important. Chapter 11. But you have arranged by measure and number and weight. This is what God said. And you shall not forget that for us in the digital industry, numbers are at the heart of what we are doing. And we shall always remember what a number represents for the philosophy, for the religion. And this is also part of what we have to discuss, what we have to work together. This place, and especially with the DLD, is a meeting place and a melting pot of all sorts of ideas, practice, approaches, applications, business models. They keep being created, developed, tested, deployed, updated. I'm very much impressed by the people here each time I come. They are outstanding scholars, they are great students, but they are also inspiring entrepreneurs. This is incredible. Every time I visit Technion or meet startups here, I'm amazed by the brain power, but also by the spirit of getting things done, even if it is in an unorganized way. I'm also amazed how things can work in a situation when not everything is fixed, not everything is on time, not everything is perfect, and how, let's say, success can come from a kind of disorganized creativity. I had a boss who told me in the past, it's better to progress in disorder than to stay aligned in order. And to a certain extent, Israel is a good example of that. How to progress in disorder. And I think I like that. These are strengths. Everybody should come and learn from you. From the youngest students here, understand the importance of practice by applying the knowledge, developing ideas into usable solutions. This culture of try out and learn is crucial for technological progress. We are trying hard in France to move a bit into this direction of not being afraid to try and maybe fail, but learn from our mistakes. And then try it again, and maybe fall again, or maybe succeed. You try to walk, if you fall, you get up and you try again. So thank you for the lessons. We'll try to be better and better into applying them. This is one of the great lessons we learned here. Success in the modern world is not based just on great ideas or finding investors, it's based on perseverance and tries. Europe is still the largest, world's biggest consumer market in terms of value. And at a time where continents are fragmenting, where international trade is at stake, I hope, as Israelis, as citizens here, you don't forget Europe. That remains a part of the free open market still existing in this world. And ahead of the US, ahead of China, ahead of India, we are a big market. But to keep it in this way, a lot of efforts are needed. We need to be more than up to date. We need to be ahead of the game. Excellence in science and technology are a must. Ability to translate this knowledge into practice, to apply it in real-life solutions, is equally crucial. And having a world-class, state-of-the-art innovation hub in Israel is a very important competitive edge for Europe. It allows balancing the Silicon Valley on one hand and the Far East on the other. This hub, just 4 hours' flight from the European capitals, combines a profound understanding of Europe with the American ideal of building success from scratch and with global ways of doing things. This is a unique blend. You are making a good use of it. For many years, decades even, we have been looking up to the Silicon Valley or to the US more generally and the way things are there. We have been in love first with Apple, then with Microsoft, then with Google, then back with Apple again. The ideal of the American dream of starting a billion-dollar business in your garage, this has been important as an inspiration, as a spur for growth, and as a driving force. But there are limitations to the Silicon Valley way of doing things. And our American friends are perfectly aware of this too, and by the way, they invest here too. They are at the crossroads facing consequences of uncontrolled growth in some areas and stagnation and decline in others in terms of industries and in terms of geographies. There are many questions to be answered about the role of the state, about the balance between economic liberty and social protection, about promoting success and being inclusive. The questions in the US are not always the same as those in Europe. Europe is different in terms of social models or the private-public balance. Not everything that works in the US will work here. We have a lot to learn from the American experience. It's a source of inspiration, but we should not be blinded by it. We have to have our own way, and I'm convinced that Israel Innovation Hub is a key element of finding this way. And we have been constant in our presence here for many years now. There have been quite some success stories in our portfolio. We had some of the companies we invested in or partnered with present even this morning in our orange breakfast on cyber defense. Let me just quote one, the most recent, Morphisec, but there are more. One of the biggest challenges I see is the absolute need of finding balance between human and digital. As Orange, we have always been involved in this reflection for a long time now. It is even expressed in the Human Inside hashtag that sums up our search for this balance. This is also a very important and interesting topic for me personally. I try to regularly find time to participate in discussions around these issues. I have met with many, many people in different forums, reuniting stakeholders with different backgrounds. There may be different angles and different opinions. There is not one single approach, but there is one thing that personally, for me, is the most important thing to remember. Technology is not a goal in itself. It is only a way of doing things for humans. A tool that may help or may hinder. A tool that may be good or bad, depending on what use we make of it. Technology is by humans and shall remain for humans. It is our shared responsibility as a community, as the digital community, to make sure that we never lose the human from sight. That this dazzling, fantastic world of opportunities ahead of us helps us and inspires, but that we should always keep at heart the human being. It is human that gives sense to technology, never the other way around. Let me leave you with this reflection. Hopefully, this gives you some food for thought for the next days. Please enjoy this great event, and thanks once more for having me here. And finally, as the new year is approaching, let me wish you Shana Tova to you all. Thank you.